the second half. Pat McAfee will get us underway. Here he comes on the approach, and this Big East opener for West Virginia is good, as on the touchback of McAfee. You know, air it out. Go into the gadget bag. Get it done. See what you can do. What do you got to lose? You're a four-touchdown underdog as they start first and 10, and a penalty right off the get-go. Well, it's not a penalty. All right, just referee crew today. Hit it by referee John McDade. Some administrative work. And here we go. Syracuse on the attack first. Late arriving crowd here. Patterson going to throw it. Pump fake. Gets it underneath. Tom Farron, tight end to the 27. Here's their leading receiver. Picks up 7 yards. Take a look at the backs and receivers for the Orange. They'd like to get Brinkley loose. Rice Moss and Tim Lane have got to come up big, catching balls and stretching the defense. Meanwhile, the offensive line, Mike Sklardowski, moves up from the second string. They move Carol Madison from left guard to right tackle. Second down from the 27 for the Orange. Farron resetting. Fumble, and Patterson's lucky to recover it. Eric Wicks was there, almost there, to make that reception or the recovery. West Virginia, they lose 3 yards on that play. On that D-line, Dykes, Liebig, and Ingram do a nice job getting pressure up front. 2 tackles for loss for Dykes. Smart guys here. McLean's the best athlete. Henry's the academic All-American. Never got anything less than an A. And there's 6 INTs in that back group, led by Eric Wicks. Vaughn Rivers returned a punt last week for a touchdown. Big third down play. The Orange, only 38% efficiency on the season. A big number for West Virginia. They're allowing 43% conversion. Blitz coming. Patterson in trouble. Dropped the ball. Picks it up. Pushes forward. Got the first down. He's a rugged individual. He ran through a tackle there. 9 yards on the pickup. Nice job inside there with Quentin Andrews getting the tackle.
Great play by the senior. He picks up the football off the drop back. Had plenty of room to step up, and then he gets knocked there. He picks up the football very alertly. The senior, very calm, takes the football and moves the chains. That's a big play. I know it only seems like a 7, 8, 9 yard gain, but a very big play early to keep momentum on Syracuse's offense and keep possession of the football.
Both of these teams do a good job in their turnover margin. West Virginia's number one and Syracuse number four, so they generally have been protecting the ball pretty well. Here's Patterson, short drop, nothing there. Comes back to his tight end, and he goes to J.J. Neshwa, junior out of Poughkeepsie, New York. Jay Henry brings him down, gain of 5.
Dave, so important to get these tight ends involved in the game early.
Tackled by Kevin.
Greg Robinson challenged his team. Hey, boys, got to go to work today.
Yeah.
Plain and simple. And we have got to eliminate mistakes. They gave up big numbers on the ground last week to Larod Stevens-Howland, 221 yards, and today they faced the number 3 rusher in the country, and Steve Slayton. Tom Farron resets on the second down play. Now run it with Brinkley, nice yardage, close to a first down. Got it to the 42-yard line. Rivers, Vaughn Rivers was there to help make the tackle. And Rich Rodriguez, the head coach of the Mountaineers of West Virginia, 4 Big East titles, defending champion in the Big East Conference. And last week, plagued by multiple penalties. And Richie said, listen, you're not going to be any Dr. Ruth, any Dr. Phil, no Oprah, no looking for your inner self. He was chewing some behind this past week in practice.
He said there'll be no holding hands, no kumbaya. We're going to go ahead and go to work. And I believe him.
And he said that with a dead straight face, too. A first down run sets up Syracuse at its own 42-yard line. Patterson drops. Got pretty good protection. Flush. Holds on to it. He's 240 pounds. Perry Patterson does a heck of a job to pick up 1.5 yards.
Patterson on the run.
Must have been tremendous coverage in that he didn't throw it. Jay Henry with the sack.
gain of one.
Well, if you can say one thing about the Orange offensively, they have to pick it up, especially today against the Mountaineers on the offensive line. They cannot put Perry Patterson underneath this duress and this pressure early in the game. And thank goodness that Perry has quick feet, even on a big frame. He goes at 242 pounds, but he still has enough elusiveness to get away. But that offensive line needs to control the Mountaineers up front.
There's a look at the O-line for the Orange. High formation on the second down and long. Blitz on the corner. They run right into it. And Brinkley taken down almost immediately. Barely got back to the line of scrimmage. Good work in there by Eric Wicks, number 41, the strong safety, returning starter from a year ago. Senior out of Perry High School in Pittsburgh.
Boy, defensive coordinator Jeff Castile loves when they can put Eric Weeks on the edge, bring him from up top. He's unaccounted for. You cannot block him. The fullback runs right by him and Stephen McDonald because he has the assignment of the defensive end. So you bring an extra guy into the box, and the Mountaineers love to pressure you, especially on third and long. Third and nine right now, Dave.
Eighth play of a drive that started at their own 20 for the Orange. Good protection, throw, catch made, first down, West Virginia territory, 46-yard line. Tim Lane went up to get it. Tonio Lewis on the coverage. Nicely done, a gain of 11.
Great catch on the outside, and credit Patterson for stepping up in the pocket, and he goes up. Rice Mosh just climbs the ladder. This is a guy that hurt his shoulder last week, played very limited against Pittsburgh in last week's loss, but comes back now early. Seven receptions on the season. You see one touchdown, but a very important catch in this first quarter.
So Moss makes the catch. Patterson, 3 of 3 passing, 23 yards. Now in West Virginia territory, Paul Shara motions to the left. Patterson going to throw it again. Deep ball, man there, and he overthrows him. Bryce Moss had big separation from the secondary, and Perry Patterson got too much on that one.
Boy, if you ever want to have one back as a quarterback, it's the guy that's streaking down the middle of the field in the seam. Rice Mosh just made a big play. Now, you can see the level here of West Virginia. Nobody retreats back, and that's why the Orange is able to get by the defensive secondary. Rice Mosh had at least two or three steps on the nearest Mountaineer defender.
Talking to Greg Robinson this week, he says, you know what, I think we can get something on their corners. See what happens here as they continue to go through the ground at Brinkley. Not too much doing there. Brinkley on the carry, sophomore from Philadelphia's West Philly High School. Loss of a yard. Greg Robinson said, looking at their corners, I think we can run by them. So it'll be interesting to see how often they test that. And look at those numbers. They give up almost 4 bills a game in the last 2 weeks. Syracuse defensively has given up 925 yards.
Well, right now, Syracuse doing a great job of keeping that Mountaineer offense on the sidelines. They just need to convert here on third and long.
2 for 2 on third down so far today for the Orange. Patterson, pretty good protection. Looking, nobody home. Boy, he's holding the ball a long time. Got him in wide open. Touchdown, Syracuse. He got it to Mike Williams. Perry Patterson won a lot of time. Connects for 47 yards in the Orange. Breakout 6-0.
Dave, we talked about playing up to the level of Perry Patterson in the open, that you had to rise to the occasion, and that's exactly what Greg Robinson's team did on that first drive. You saw Rice Mosh climb the ladder, keep the drive alive, and that time the young freshman, he got his first collegiate touchdown last week against the Panthers. Now he goes 47 yards for his second touchdown of the young season.
Give Patterson all kinds of credit for staying alive. Give the O-line credit. A reshuffled offensive line as we look at Patrick Shadle from Morgantown High School. Wanted to come here, didn't have a scholarship available, so they didn't take him. And Richie Rodriguez wanted somebody who could kick immediately. But an exuberant Perry Patterson kept that play alive. 11 plays in 80 yards and 6:24 in the Orange. Surprisingly, breakout on top on number 5, West Virginia.
Sidelines and score on their first drive.
Carney with the kick, and he booms one into the end zone. They thought about bringing it out, but he just got Darius Renaud.
Great block that sets it up right here. Watch the block The sophomore tailback, Curtis Brinkley, steps up, but then to keep the play alive, Perry Patterson wanted to throw it shorter, and then he found his receiver, his freshman, Mike Williams, standing about the three-yard line saying, Perry, I'm all alone, just get it out here. And that's sometimes the toughest throw to make, but Mike Williams looks the football in, secures the catch, and secures the 7-0 lead.
For you old-timers, that looked like Jimmy Orr in the Super Bowl III against the Jets, was wide open, and Earl Morrall never saw him on a flea flicker. Here's West Virginia starting at its own 20, down for the first time this season. Slayton slowed up in there and then gang tackled. Gain of two. A.J. Brown, who moves over to linebacker from safety, makes the tackle. Patrick White didn't start until middle portions of last year. Very efficient in terms of running the ball. Big question nationally, can he throw the ball successfully over a significant part of time? Well, they haven't had to because this is a great running team. Second down play from the 23. This is where he's dangerous. Open space. Picks up about 5 to the 26-yard line. Here's a look at the performers on the offense. You've met Slayton and Schmidt. Gonzalez, they like him. Miles is a game breaker, and ditto Darius Miles. Great speed on the edge there. Outstanding offensive line led by the All-American Dan Moses. He and Sheffield are two big tough guys on that O-line. Third down and 4, the 26. Get it outside to the 32-yard line. That's a first down for West Virginia. Nice throw. They get it to Darius Renaud. That's his 16th catch as we look at the D-line. These are the guys that are racking up a lot of sacks coming in, led by Jamil McLean. The linebackers, a couple of changes. A.J. Brown moves from the secondary. K.J. Smith and Luke Kane. Kane moves over, replacing Jerry Mackey. And in that secondary, Joe Fields, a former quarterback. And here's West Virginia right back. And this one, they go to the house. Nobody's going to get him. Touchdown, West Virginia. Big run for the Mountaineers of 69 yards. They get it to Patrick White. Takes it all the way in. The quarterback, we said he was one of the best runners in the country. So the response by West Virginia is swift. Longest play from scrimmage this season for the Mountaineers.
69 yards goes the quarterback, Patrick White. Last week he had 76 yards rushing and 2 touchdowns, so he's closing in on his effort on the first or second run of the game for that quarterback.
Tie ball game at 6:49 to go. 4 plays, 80 yards, and a 147, and the Mountaineers are right back at 7. East football here at Morgantown, West Virginia. Number 5, West Virginia, right back in this game on a 69-yard run by Patrick White. 8th consecutive game with a touchdown on their first drive for the Mountaineers, and they do it so swift. 4 plays, 80 yards, and 147.
That's the problem if you're facing this West Virginia offense. They can score. It doesn't take them very long. And they usually do it on their first drive. As you said, Dave, eight times in a row they've scored on that opening drive dating back to last year. They're just so, so dangerous offensively.
McAfee booms another one. This one has a chance and will be returned. Brinkley's got it. 25 and a couple of good legs. Good coverage by the Mountaineers on 20-yard return.
There's only a couple ways you can defend this freeze option, and sometimes you get the flow way down. You can see the big gashing lanes to the right side that Patrick White is able to just bounce to the outside because Jamil McLean, the defensive end, is way down here. He's got his nose in the backfield. Rich Rodriguez says that his quarterback, Patrick White, is as good as anybody he's had in his decision-making. That time, he made a great decision.
Got some serious speed, too, once he got to the edge. From the 26, first and 10 for the Orange. It's Tim Lane in motion. Got a work-off tackle. Good persistence in there by DeLon Carter. He was brilliant 2 weeks ago with a 4-touchdown performance at home and a win against Wyoming. Eric Wicks on the tackle. Gain of 7. For the Mountaineers, very consistent under Rich Rodriguez and company this year. That's why they're number five in the country. Where do you think they're going to be ranked based on what happens today, obviously, John, but with the BCS, this being the BCS first week, and it comes out tomorrow?
Well, with the strength of schedule, it'll probably be lower than many Mountaineer fans would like them to be.
Carter crossed the 35 to the 36, close to a first down. West Virginia's strength of schedule, number 99 in the country. Boo McLean made the tackle.
And that's not saying that they're not a quality team and they don't deserve to be up in the top four or the top three or the top five, but just that's going to happen, and that's probably some of the problem that goes into ranking people in the beginning of the season and how far you have to go to get to number one.
We'll bring out the chain game for measurement. John McDade, the referee. Ron Kumiega is the umpire. Troy Gray is the linesman. Line judge is Hugh Campbell. Side judge is Brian Platt. Field judge is Robert Solikowski. The back judge is Keith Washington. Good Big East crew.
I think Greg Robinson, offensively, he still has to stay aggressive. But West Virginia was able to answer. They have to stay aggressive, and they have to keep Perry Patterson moving the pocket, but not only run the football, but throw it to the tight end. Take a shot downfield. They believe they can run by West Virginia. They have to continue to keep the pressure on this defense.
Mike Williams, a guy they like. Perry Patterson told us last week he's a basketball player playing football. He can go up and get it. He looks for Williams. Nothing there. Williams down the field. He broke it off. Perry thought he was going to continue to go deep, and an incomplete on that play. Pretty good coverage over there.
And Perry Patterson wants covering. Dave, he wants to talk to his freshman wide receiver because he crossed him up a little bit. Perry Patterson just gets flushed a little bit, thought he was going to go on a takeoff, and then decided to stop, and that could have been an easy pick in that defensive secondary for the Mountaineers. That ball luckily was thrown out of bounds.
That's inexperience there, right? Because wouldn't you tell your receiver normally, hey, just keep going, I'll find him.
Yeah.
Perry Patterson can throw the ball, throw it out of the building.
And especially at Mike Williams, 6'2", he can climb the ladder, as he's proven already this game.
Second down and 10 at the 36. Blitz coming. Patterson didn't get rid of it. Blitz takes him down inside the 30. Jay Henry, the academic All-American. Perry Patterson saying, hey, what happened? 7 yards on the loss.
Just pressure right in the face of Perry Patterson. Jay Henry comes right up the middle. No one really picks him up. A free blitzer. Patterson does a good job initially of trying to sidestep Henry, but Henry hangs on for the sack.
Third and 17 at the 29 coming up. 7-7 bowl game. Early offensive excitement here. Perry Patterson, 47 yards to Mike Williams. West Virginia responds immediately with a 69-yard run by Patrick White. Big ball downfield, caught, first down, Syracuse, West Virginia territory at the 49-yard line. They got it to Mike Williams again for 22 yards. Quentin Andrews on the coverage for the Mountaineers. Perry Patterson coming out, ripping.
That's a big-time throw by Perry Patterson. Just a rocket shot off the left side. Perfect timing and great anticipation by Perry Patterson of letting the football go before the receiver was out of his break. And then Mike Williams goes up and attacks the football. Great timing on the pass offense by the Orange.
4 for 4 on third down. And just what Patterson said, a basketball player going up making plays. There's Moss going in motion on the ground with Carter for about 3 or 4. Sets up a very friendly second down situation. Keelan Dykes there. Defensive end makes the play.
Like the way the Orange running backs are hitting the hole aggressively. They're doing a good job. There's not a lot of running room. But Delone Carter that time, he's known as the cutback runner of the two. Curtis Brinkley more the slasher. Delone Carter will get through that hole, and he has a tendency to cut that football back.
John, let's remind everybody, too, that Syracuse is without their best big play guy, Taj Smith. Broke a collarbone back on the 23rd of September. He was a guy that was 19 yards per catch. Second down and 6 at the 45. They run a toss play. And swarmed under very nicely. Well covered by West Virginia. No gain on that play with Delon Carter being tackled by Bobby Hathaway. Gorgeous day here for football, everybody. Glad you could join us here at Mountaineer Field. Morgantown, West Virginia. I'm Dave Sims with John Congemi and Sarah Kustak. Big offense early on here, not by just West Virginia, also by the Syracuse Orange. Scores tied at 7.
Plenty of time left here in the first quarter. Now Perry Patterson going to burn a timeout. It's first to three. And Greg Robinson, Brian White and company will chat things over. 2:48 to go here in the first quarter. Perry Patterson with the touchdown to his credit. He's got a good rhythm there.
Dave, he's taking control of this football game, and that's what he needs to do. The senior quarterback playing at the highest level he's played in his career.
Off to a good start, converting on third down. 4 for 4 for the Orange. Perry Patterson told us last week he's been watching a lot of tape of Matt Leinart. Leinart's last 2 years in Syracuse, Southern Cal. And a poise is showing, except for that pass. That's not a good throw, but he has been, as you mentioned, John, he's been in control. Incomplete as they tried to get it to Tommy Farron. First time they don't convert on a fourth down.
And you have to give credit to the Mountaineers, that front seven that time put a lot of pressure on Patterson. Early in this game, he's been able to use his legs and his feet to elude pressure, get around it, and get rid of the football. That time, he was under duress and just really threw it away.
Vaughn Rivers, who returned a punt 50 yards for touchdown, the final score in last week's win at Mississippi State, 42-14. Going to get this punt from Brendan Kearney. Kearney gets one up in the air, hangs it nicely inside the six into the end zone. 4.2 seconds on the hang time, a 45-yard punt at Nets 25. So West Virginia will put it in play from its own 20-yard line. Richie Rodriguez couldn't be more comfortable. A West Virginia guy, went to school here, was a walk-on for Don Nalen. He replaced Don Nalen as coach, has succeeded him. Coach Nalen's here. Look at the numbers he's put up. 3 consecutive Big East titles and 2-time Coach of the Year in the Big East.
He's done a terrific job, and he gets the right kids to play in his system. They love to play at a fast tempo, and when they're playing fast, they're usually winning football games.
White gives to Slayton. Oh, good defensive play by Syracuse. Chris Thorner in there, no gain. A D tackle making a play. Well done.
Big, strong defensive tackle. Chris Thorner, 6'4", 299 pounds. The senior does a great job of creating a stalemate right on the inside. And then he just reaches that hand outside for the tackle.
Toss play coming to the near side. Slayton strung it out. Again, a fine defensive play. Now, K.J. Smith should get a big assist. Jameel McClain makes the tackle, but K.J. blew up the interference. Number 8, the middle linebacker.
Yeah, made the run, bounce to the outside, and Calvin Smith is a big part of this defense, and Jameel McClain does a great job of running it down, but that's the guy in the middle with space. He allows McClain to get to that outside and get the tackle.
Third down and 10 from the 20. Quiet crowd here as White backs the throw. Got a man down there, threw his hands, incomplete at the 35-yard line. And he tried to get it in. Joe Fields covering down there. And they tried to get that into Tito Gonzalez.
They may come back to that play later because Darius Reynard was coming in on the under, wide open. It looked like he could have got out to the back end, but White decides to try to push it in the hole down the field and threw it a little bit high and outside.
Bruce Williams back to get the punt from Kozlowski. First time we've seen Scott, who's second in the conference, of Joe Radigan. Sailor, far side, good roll inside the 40. A low line drive, only in the air for 3.1 seconds, but it covers 44 yards. Well, West Virginia does, they like to do things a little bit differently in their punt game.
And they'll go to the outside and really roll punt, and they do a great job. Historically, the last few years, they've done a good job of rolling outside and punting on the run, and Kozlowski does a nice job of getting that out there, 44 yards for the Mountaineers, and really not great field position, but decent field position for the Orange.
Phil Brady made a heck of a rep here at West Virginia the last few years. Hero in the Sugar Bowl. Orange taking over, half roll. Patterson in trouble, looking for a deep ball. Got a man running free and broken up at the final second. Should have been an INT for Quentin Andrews. He already has 2 on the season. Big hitter out of Opa-locka, Florida. Antonio Lewis, second team all performer, breaking that play up. There is number 6. He's got 2 picks this year.
Patterson wanted to go deep to the field. He does a good job again of eluding pressure, but there's a safety coming from the edge off off the hash to the sideline. That ball just hangs up a little bit too long, and a good break on the football by Antonio Lewis. Should have been a pick. He has two on the season.
Second down play from the 36. Farron in motion. That's going to be
somebody had him move.
Yeah, somebody, I think, the right side of the O-line.
He had plenty of time on the 25-second clock.
All star. Number 64 offense. 5-yard penalty from the line of scrimmage. Remains second down.
Corey Shavers, the left tackle, sophomore out of Jamesville, New York. All-state first teamer in high school.
Dave, this is the problem they ran into last week against Pittsburgh. They started killing themselves with holding penalties, procedure penalties, different things that would start them at first and 15, second and 20, and Greg Robinson really addressed that situation on the offensive line by moving guys around and getting some different players in to start the game.
Eugene Newsom out at right tackle. They moved Carol Madison over from left guard. Greg last week said, hey, we kept throwing a wet blanket over ourselves. Quick hitter for about five with Brinkley. But Brinkley, Big East best in 2006 with the 4 touchdowns, most points, most TDs, most rushing TDs.
And Brinkley's more of the slasher, and he's an excellent acceleration through the hole. And that's what they need to do. Offensive comparison today, 21 plays already for the Orange for 114 yards. The Mountaineers offensively have only been on the field 7 times.
Should be the last play, first quarter. It's a big one, third and long for the Orange. Blitz, Sean Blitz comes. Patterson hangs, steps up, eludes, holds on to it. And I tell you what, the big thing today, John, and you can appreciate this as a quarterback, his receivers are doing a bad job getting separation from defenders. They're, West Virginia's clearly faster than Syracuse.
They're doing a great job of initially covering up from the back end because Perry Patterson has to elude 2 or 3 players before he can look downfield.
First quarter in the books and a good start in this Big East contest. The opener for West Virginia. Mike Williams, though, put a damper on it early, but Pat White counted. Tied it.